The results of more than 3 weeks of talks among Sudan's opposition leaders bearing fruit. After numerous meetings between the armed groups of the coalition, known as the Forces for Freedom and Change, and the civilian components of the coalition, the two sides reached a deal.
We are a coalition, a united coalition, but we also think that Sudan's Revolutionary Front, the armed groups coalition, has to be part of this transitional government so we will have more talks. Our representation at all levels will ensure that peace is achieved and can guarantee a stable transitional period.
The two sides also agreed to form a hierarchy to lead the opposition coalition, something it had lacked since it was established in January. It ends tension between the coalition leaders, especially after members signed an initial power-sharing agreement with Sudan's military council in Khartoum last week. That was done without the consent of the armed groups. Some of them have been fighting the government for over 18 years and want some level of representation in a transitional government.
We have agreed to speed up the formation of a civilian transitional government, and the first step is ensuring peace. These talks reached a comprehensive peace agreement with armed groups. We haven't yet decided who will hold positions in a transitional government.
The deal paves way for the opposition to resume talks and sign a final agreement with the military junta. The junta is currently ruling Sudan, after ousting the country's longtime ruler Omar al-Bashir in a military coup in April following months of anti-government protests. On Wednesday, the military council said a coup attempt was made to try to overthrow it.
The military forces were able to uncover the details of the plan and the participants, led by General Hashim Abdul Muttalib Ahmed, the military joint chief of staff, and a number of military officers and senior members of the National Intelligence and Security Service. This is in addition to leaders from the Islamic movement and the National Congress Party. They have been taken into custody.
As the opposition comes out seemingly united from the talks in Addis Ababa, people in Sudan continue to wait for not only a final deal between the coalition and the military junta, but for the demands for civilian rule and accountability to be met. They say they want all signs of elements of the former government gone to believe that the revolution they started is victorious. Hiba Morgan, Al Jazeera, Addis Ababa.